Get ready to match the stars from Days of Our Lives. Wesley Yore, Brett Summers, Carl Gibson Riley, from Angie Generally Scott, from the Pricey Right, Tom Barker, and Marsha Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers!
Well done. Thank you, friends. Got a lively group there and a good bunch on the stage. And we've got this guy for the first time. How do you spell your name?
E-U-R-E.
E-U-R-E. And it's pronounced?
Your.
Your.
Right.
Your.
Your.
Not your. It is not Y-O-U-R. It is E-U-R-E, which is your.
You tell him, honey.
Your. Okay, Wesley, welcome.
Thank you.
Nice to have you with us. Wesley Yore.
Gee!
And your name was?
My name is Ellen Kaplan and Chuck Wolcott over here. Would you welcome them, please? Good luck to both of you. Two games for each of you, remember that. If you'd like to get acquainted, Chuck, let's hear about you, please.
I'm a firefighter with the Los Angeles Fire Department.
Yeah. All right.
Good, how are you?
I have a wife and a son, Bryce, 1 year old.
Oh. Bryce is 1 year old?
Right.
Well, I'll bet he's a cute kid, too.
I think so.
Have a mustache like yours?
Not yet.
Not yet. Well, he'll grow one. Okay. All right, Ellen, how about you? What's the story of your life?
Well, I'm a housewife and a mother of a 2.5-year-old son. And in my not-so-spare time, I give tours of the UCLA Art Gallery.
Oh, you do?
Yes. The White Gallery and the Sculpture Gardens.
They've got those garden sculptures are absolutely beautiful there.
They are.
That's something worth seeing if any of you people are going to be in the Los Angeles area. All right, shall we begin the first game here? Chuck, you have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B it is for you. Al said, I'm never going back to that rotten bowling alley. Instead of a bowling ball, some guy tried to roll me down the lane by sticking his fingers in my blank.
To a firehouse in San Francisco, Engine 28, and they took care of me.
Oh, really?
No.
Sure it wasn't the other way around.
Oh, the vapes.
I better get away from there. All right, friendly bunch over there. Chuck, Al said I'm never going back to that rotten bowling alley. Instead of a bowling ball, some guy tried to roll me down the lane by sticking his fingers in my blank.
In my ears.
Ears, he said. Ears. Now, wait a minute.
Oh,
hold on just a second. Are you awing just because you tuned in the show once or twice and you heard people awing and ooing? Or you really think that's a rotten answer? Now, are you sincere? Because that happens to be a very good answer. We've got some dreadful questions coming up. You'll have plenty of chance to awe. So don't awe on the good ones. Okay, Wesley.
It was real attractive. His nose.
His nose. Yeah. Oh, I see. You think nose is better than ears. Is that the idea? All right. Don't let me intimidate you.
You boo away to your heart's content, hon. Nostrils.
Nostrils.
I said El Nozo.
El Nozo. So the upper tier, all of them said nose, Chuck. Chuck is looking for a pair of ears. Hey, where'd you get them their ears at?
Instead of shell ears.
Yes.
Fine.
I said ears.
Ears.
One for Chuck.
Some guy tried to roll me down the bowling lane by sticking his fingers in my...
Oh, you see, I was once a firefighter at Firehouse 28.
That's...
Was she good?
Shirt,
they had this zany girl living next door there. Yes, that's where I got this shirt. You like this shirt?
Yeah, I think that's very
I have
attractive.
A green one just like it. Would you like to have me wear it tomorrow?
The green shirt tomorrow?
Yeah. They'll give our audience something to look forward to. I said ears.
Ears and
ears.
All right, super tough. Are you a ear person or a nose person?
How personal. I'm available to live next door to firehouses.
Oh, all right.
I hate to match those rowdy people out there, but I said nose.
Nose, okay. Two for Chuck, Ellen. Let's see what we have for you here.
And I'm a back person, Gene.
You're a what?
Back person.
Oh, a back person.
She is indeed.
Really?
Yes.
Shall we explore that further? Frank said... This t-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with an entire fleet of ships on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw. T-shirts. All right, Ellen. Frank said this t-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with an entire fleet of ships on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Boobs.
Well, now, you really didn't understand the question, though. Read it one more time. We can't give you another chance because we have to accept your answer. Hmm? She had these ships. Well, never mind. What'd you say?
Something I can look through, her portholes.
Portholes. All right. What do you got there?
You know, I wasn't going to wear my retainer.
Yeah.
But once I found Wesley was on the show.
You wanted to get a youthful appearance. Yes, sir. Of course.
Portholes.
Portholes. Stole it from him or vice versa.
I did not steal it from him.
You stole it from him.
No, I did not steal it from him either.
All right. Charles.
Oh, so sad. Guns and turrets.
Guns and turrets.
Guns and turrets.
He knows boat talk.
Well, anything nautical would have been a good response.
I was thinking
here.
Of gunboats.
You were thinking of gunboats. Yes. Well, that would have been better. I don't think it would have matched. Deborah Lee, what have you got here? She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
I was under pressure, you know, because I was the last one. So I said cannons. You know.
That happened to be a very good answer. Yeah, anything nautical. Show us something nautical.
Well, cannons is not nautical.
Shh, now wait, now let it go.
Well, I used to work at Firehouse 28. Destroyer.
There's a good one. Very good.
Oh, honey, it's not my area, you know what I mean? I don't know your boat lingo.
You don't?
No, I'm the winner of this year's Golden Dramamine Award. I've gotten sick on absolutely every boat I was ever on. A little human interest, Gene. I've got a million of them, honey. So all I could think of was rudders.
Rudders is all right.
Yeah, it's okay. Something to do with the boat.
That's something to do with the boat. Yeah.
You can't see rudders.
You leave her alone, Chuck. Rudders does not stink. Okay, here we are at the end of round one. 2-0 is the score. Round two coming up right now. This for you. Okay, round two. Now, Chuck, since you're ahead, we'll ask you to go first.
B, please.
All right, four people will play. Hey, did you hear what happened to Farmer Brown at the zoo?
No, darling.
I'll tell you what happened to Farmer Brown at the zoo. He got drunk and tried to blank a rhino. Chuck, did you hear what happened to Farmer Brown at the zoo? He got drunk and tried to blank a rhino.
Ride a rhino.
Ride a rhino?
Oh, they are rough.
Ride a rhino is what he said. That would be difficult, wouldn't it?
Yes, well, the only way to ride a rhino is to first kiss him.
Uh-huh.
Right? Hey!
That would be difficult, too, because they got such big lips.
Yes. Try to get past the horns.
Yes. Know,
it's very difficult.
Yes, ma'am?
Oh, honey, he was just carried away thinking about...
Oh, sure, of course.
Yeah. It's okay.
You like older women, right, Leslie? Older women turn you on?
Sure.
Older women turn you on?
Sure. When it gets to be my age, almost anything does.
Some of us don't admit it, Brett.
I said milk.
Yay!
Hey! That's an upside-down udder.
Okay.
She lived next to a firehouse, and they moved from Canoga Park to Little Milk.
Milk a rhino. Milk a rhino would be tougher than riding a rhino, wouldn't it? Now, Marcia, we come to you, my dear.
Do we, Gene?
Yes, this farmer. He got drunk at the zoo. He tried to do something to a rhino.
I know farm talk.
You do farm talk?
I know farm talk. That's an area. I grew up in farm country.
You grew up in farm country?
That's what I said, Gene.
What
state? Are your ears going to? Iowa. Iowa. Read my lips.
Yes.
Iowa.
Iowa.
That's
the tall
where
corn
the tall
grows.
Corn grows. Right. Plow.
Plow a rhino. You mean he tried to use the rhino as a beast of
not
burden?
Not necessary.
Don't ask her to explain.
And yet, or?
Not necessary.
All right. Now, Ellen, here's the way it is. You need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Harry said, inflation is getting so bad.
How bad is it?
Yesterday, I went into the bank and saw a stack of dollar bills with a sign in front that said, blank. I personally hate this question. And I told them so before the show, but they insisted on using it.
You know why I hate it?
Can I say it?
Because it's depressing.
Yes.
It is. Oh, that's good.
But it should be so hard to match. I mean,
no, that happens to be the definitive answer. Steal his answer.
Don't steal my answer.
Steal his answer.
Don't
answer.
No.
No, I swear it was my answer.
Is this adorable?
Adorable. Hate the sheriff. That's the answer. I know it comes from that.
Ellen, Harry said inflation is getting so bad. Yesterday, I went into the bank, and I saw a stack of dollar bills with a sign in front that said, blank.
Take one.
Take one. I believe she came up with the response.
Well, I came up with the non-response. You see, I figured it's getting so bad that you can't even buy them. Not for sale.
They're getting scarce. Okay.
I said kindling for sale.
Kindling for sale. Start a fire with the dollar bills. Why not?
Start a fire with the dollar bill.
Cheapest paper.
Can't use it for anything else.
You know, Brett Stennis is the only one that has vodka lollipops. Extinct species.
Extinct species. The dollar bill. Ellen is looking for the response, take one. Stack of dollar bills in a bank with a sign in front that said, take one.
I said, come and get it, it's free.
Come and get it, it's free. Now, wait a minute.
Yeah,
think about that.
That was
mad.
Oh, good. They've already lit the lights.
All right, 2-1. There we go.
Come and get it.
Yes, sir.
This audience with which you have had such difficulty will love, take one. They're free.
High score over
well,
there.
Well, I believe in being pithy. Pithy and terse, my
yes,
attorneys.
Right.
I just said free.
Free. We'll spin you back later to play game number two. And while we're spinning him off, we'll spin a message for you. You hurry back to see how much money she wins. Ellen's up here for the first time. Have a go at the big money. Good luck to you, my dear. Here's the way it goes. We polled a studio audience in this very room not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank hip. If you say the answer they wrote down most often, we give you $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And if you match a third, you get $100. Now, you can call on three of our six stars for some suggested answers here, but I would advise you to call on the stars only who have eyeball contact with you. If they're avoiding your eyes, that means they don't know nothing.
Okay.
All right?
Bob.
Hip, hip.
Hip, hip. Hip, hip. All right.
Brett.
I'm hip, I'm hip.
I'm hip, I'm hip. You got two now.
Okay. Charles.
Well, my,
here.
I know what I'm saying, sweetheart. What my grandfather told me how to shoot from the hip.
Shoot from the hip. So those are the three they've given you. Shoot from the hip, I'm hip, and hip hip.
Or hula hip.
Not hula hip, there. Now, you have an option of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own.
Shoot from the hip.
Shoot from the hip is what she says. Let's find out if it's up there. You don't agree with that, do you? No. What would you say? Rose hips. What's that?
I thought of rose hips, but that's with an S on the end, so I didn't know if that was going to work out.
No. You shouldn't pay attention to plurals here or singulars or any of that stuff. Well, let's see if shoot from the hip is up there under the $100 response. Rose hip is there.
Oh, honey, down the bottom anyway.
All right. Let's take a look at the $250 number. Hip, hip. That's Bob's answer. Last chance from shoot from the hip. May we see the big one. Broken hip. Broken hip. Well, Ellen, I'm sorry. You really struck out there, didn't you? Let's get Chuck Wolcott here and play another game, and you'll have another go at it. Here he comes back. Here we go with Chuck Wolcott. welcome.
Thank you.
A short break for you there. Now, let's have another go at it here. Game number two is the final game for the two of you. Chuck, A or B?
I'll stick with B.
B it is for Chuck. Tom said, I'm staying in the world's smallest hotel room. Every time the...
Oh, boo!
You really want to do it? Okay. Tom said, I'm staying in the world's smallest hotel room.
How small is it?
You're a willing bunch, I must say that for you. Every time the maid opens the door, she crushes my blank. Spelling is not an important matter here. You think you're getting harder? Is it the question getting harder, or are you losing your grip? Oh, poor girl. What does that say there?
New York.
New York, a wonderful town.
The Bronx is up and the battery's down.
New York. What's that?
The Bronx is up and the battery's down.
Correct.
Doo-da, doo-da.
Hey,
New York,
people riding a hole in the ground. So big they had to name it twice. New York, New York. Charles is the one we're waiting for.
Even the muggers wear I love New York buttons.
Chuck.
Yo!
I'm talking to Chuck Wolcott over here.
Oh.
I'm talking to this guy over here. Okay? Okay.
Fine by me.
Tom said, I'm staying in the world's smallest hotel room. Every time the maid opens a door, she crushes my blank.
The only thing I can think of is crushes my head.
My head?
Yeah.
A gory, sanguinary picture. What do you say?
This man is after my own gore, I think. Face.
How about that?
Yeah, that's the man.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I thought he'd strike out completely on that.
We're both sick.
What have you got there for
us? I figured his whole body just went crashing up against the wall and just crushed his little ribs to death.
His ribs? Yes, sir?
Or ribettes, if you were. Hello, darling. I'm so glad to see you. Where'd you get that awful shirt? And that awful answer.
You mustn't read in advance of his holding it up there and needle him that way. You mustn't do that, Brett.
Oh, okay.
You mustn't do that.
Show you a nice answer, honey, folks.
Brett, when I am running the show, you lay out. You see, you just shut up completely.
It is the part.
And it'll work a lot better that way, you see.
Gotcha.
One MC per show is, you know,
they... Want to borrow my retainers?
Way too many.
Now, Chuck, we're ready
I wouldn't turn on you, Gene.
No, you wouldn't.
I wouldn't.
Sell out.
But you will be quiet. Okay, Chuck, show.
I promise.
Pillows.
Pillows.
I forgot the question.
I forgot the question, too.
What was the question?
Every time the maid...
Stop.
Every time the maid opens the door, she crushes my pillows.
Good.
I'm so glad he said that, because now I don't feel as bad about my answer. I said suitcase.
Suitcase. Well, I guess it could be anything that's in the hotel room or any part of him or of his wife.
That was terrible,
like that.
Deborah.
I assumed that he was a very elegant fellow, and although I didn't know how to spell it, I mean boutonniere.
Boutonniere, right.
Which got about as little as anything I've ever said on this show.
Well, Bob, the way it works here, when you give little, you get little.
I was about to agree with you that this audience was not the greatest audience you've ever had.
No, it just was a rotten answer. You can't crawl out of it. No.
When you start firing, tell me I'll move.
I'll tell you right now that we will not be passing out refrigerators today.
Oh.
Well, maybe to the girl on the set.
Yeah, the one who applauded, isn't it? All right, Miss Marcia, honey. Every time the maid opens the door, she crushes my...
I don't know.
You don't know.
Oh, I wrote something down, though. Let's see what I wrote. Well, now, see, I was thinking about the wrong end. I said toe.
Toe. All right.
So what is the definitive answer?
What is the definitive... Marcia, what's a definitive answer? Ira, what's it... What? Wife.
Oh, wife.
Wife.
Crushes my wife.
Yes.
I think boutonniere is funnier than that.
Of course, now, I don't Ellen, know. We have a round one question for you, but not now. Now we have this for you. It's lovely here. Nice and cool here.
Nice
yes.
Fan.
Oh, lovely. Got that fan going there?
I think I'm going to sneeze.
No.
Look at the lights.
Yeah, look at the lights and you won't sneeze. Listen, Wesley, how was it on your first outing here? I know you've done other game shows, and you're a personable, handsome young fellow and a gifted guy, but what is it from your standpoint?
It's been fabulous, especially sitting next to this beauty here.
Uh-huh.
I think she's real neat.
Oh.
Be careful, you could get her acne.
Gene Raymond here, join us tomorrow or whenever for Match Game. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive the new Litton Air Meal in One microwave oven that fits easily over your range with built-in vent and light. Nobody knows more about microwave cooking than Litton. And for Merrill, this fireplace insert, turn your fireplace into a furnace. Efficient airtight circulates heat by means of a large built-in blower. Features decorative glass door and energy-efficient home accessory from Merrill. It's the Agfa Gilbert Optima 35mm camera. For its built-in electronic flash, four-element, 2.8 lens of focus from 3 feet to infinity, and extra-large viewfinder, made in Germany by Agfa Gilbert. And quick and tender, the Oriental noodle side dish that adds new delight to dinner. Cooks in just 3 minutes, comes in three delicious flavors, quick and tender, from Nissan Foods. And Snowy the Leech, now with new advanced stain-fighting action. Powerful new ingredients that work on the toughest stains. New advanced formula, Snowy.
Late Night Games continues in a moment with Laura and Steve. Then, take a spin of the Wheel of Fortune.
Ahmad Lutz and Bill Tubman production. This program was edited for broadcast.